we can say thermal dynamic means balance of energy, work and heat. So if a system is in thermodynamic equilibrium, no spontaneous change in any macroscopic property is observed as the system is isolated from its surrounding. Here, the term macroscopic property refers to those properties which depend upon the size of the system. For example, pressure of a system, its volume, its entropy content, etc. So when a system is in a state of thermodynamic equilibrium, it is observed that some thermodynamic potentials like Gibbs free energy gets minimized. On the other hand, its entropy content gets maximized for given conditions. Overall, we see that thermodynamic equilibrium refers to a unique stable stationary state that is approached are eventually reached as system interacts with its surrounding over a long period of time. There are three types of thermodynamic equilibrium. First one is thermal equilibrium, second one is chemical equilibrium, and third one is mechanical equilibrium. So first of all, I will talk about thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium is generally associated with zeroth law of thermodynamics. It states that a system is said to be in thermal equilibrium when there is no temperature difference present and temperature remains equal at all points of the system with passing time. More precisely, we can say there exists no temperature gradient between the system and also between system and surrounding, so that there is no transfer of heat from one point to another point. A very common example we observe in our daily life is hot cup of tea. Initially, hot cup of tea has a higher temperature as compared to the surrounding atmosphere. So initially it is not in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding. But when we keep this cup of tea for a longer duration of time, it starts emitting heat by thermal radiation process to the environment. And it keeps doing radiating heat until it finally comes to a temperature which is same as the temperature of the environment. Once it came to temperature similar to the environment, its temperature remains same with the time. So the moment at which cup of tea comes in thermal equilibrium with its surrounding, we call it a thermal equilibrium. Second one is mechanical equilibrium. So generally speaking, a system is said to be in mechanical equilibrium when there is no unbalanced forces within the system or between the system and surroundings. So more importantly, we can say the pressure in the system is same at all the points and does not change with passing time. Here we take example of a cylinder which consists of a movable wall inside it. I have shown here three situations, first, second and third. In first case, we see that this movable wall separates the cylinder into parts. Left part has higher pressure and right part has lower pressure. So the left side of the wall experiences more force than right one. Resultant force is towards right side. So this movable ball keep moving towards right, because there is difference in pressure of the two parts. Similar situation is in case second. Here the left part has lower pressure and right part has a higher pressure. So this right side of this wall experiences a net force towards left side. So in both situation we see that there exists a pressure gradient which causes mobile wall to move left or right depending upon direction of the force. Now we will talk about third case. In this case, left and right both part have equal pressures. So this mobile ball experiences equal force from both the sides. So net force, resultant force is zero. Therefore, this mobile ball remains fixed at its position and is said to be in mechanical equilibrium. So in case of mechanical equilibrium, both the parts of the cylinder have same pressure and there is no unbalanced forces. Therefore, there is no acceleration or there is no situation of turbulence inside the system. So this is very common example which we can observe in our daily life. Now I will talk about third situation. This is of thermal for chemical equilibrium. A system is said to be in chemical equilibrium if no chemical reaction takes place inside the system or between the system and surrounding, and also there takes place no exchange of matter from one part of the system to the other due to diffusion process. More precisely, we can say chemical composition will be same throughout the system and this will not vary with time. Then only we can say the system is in chemical equilibrium. Also, we can say two systems to be in chemical equilibrium with each other when their chemical potentials are same. So mathematically, we will say two systems to be in chemical equilibrium when they have same value of chemical potentials. So a system will be said in the state of thermodynamic equilibrium if all three conditions of mechanical, chemical, and thermal equilibrium are simultaneously fulfilled. Otherwise, if any one of the conditions will not be fulfilled, the system is said to be in the state of non-equilibrium. So there are unbalanced forces and unbalanced potential inside the system. Thank you.